capable of setting the meet record. This is her senior season.
And we got here a couple of days ago and we started talking to the coaches about Payton Chadwick. All those coaches said, watch Janique Brown. She beats Payton on a regular basis in practice.
And her personal best is 8.04, so right on pace with what Payton did in qualifying.
Terrible reaction to the gun by Payton Chadwick. She's way back. Tonia Marshall of LSU. And now comes Janique Brown, and Chadwick comes all the way back from one of the worst starts ever. 8:02, the winning time. They're having a tough time separating them. It's going to be 1-2 Arkansas, though.
What a remarkable recovery from Payton Chadwick. As you mentioned, Dwight, after that rough start to recover, Chadwick looks like 8.01, followed by Janique Brown in 8:02. Tonia Marshall of LSU will be in third, so a huge points opportunity right there for Arkansas. But man, nothing really went the way of Payton Chadwick out of the gun. Janique Brown got out very, very well, and Payton Chadwick certainly had some work to do midway through that race, found another gear and recovered incredibly well, finding that other gear and really, really smooth all the way through the finish.
That is all experience. She did not panic after that absolutely horrific start, and with a little bit of a limp there with Janique Brown. But the winner is downstairs with Jill.
You told me yesterday those first three steps out of the blocks is what you needed to have in this race. What happened at the start?
The first three steps. I didn't execute the first three steps. Still ran 8:01. So like I told you, once the whole race clicks, there's no telling what I can run.
Being able to come back and build that speed in between those hurdles, what does that tell you where your racing is right now?
In between, I'm really fast. I'm strong, so I know I have that. But, again, I just need that block start to really come together for me.
Thanks, Payton.
Yep.